Hello, everyone. Once again, welcome to another edition of Bonita Webinars. My name is Nicola, and I'm part of the marketing team based here in North America. Through these webinars, we try to give you more insights into facilitating the adoption of our Bonita platform and how to identify and apply innovative approaches. The versatility of Bonita usage is very widespread, and as you may already know, you can find us in the cloud, in adaptive case management, in collaboration with RPA, robotic process automation, and many other technologies. If you're not, however, if you've missed some of these webinars or some of these case studies, since they're all posted on our website, on our YouTube channel, and you can find many materials on those places. To put Bonitasoft into a short perspective and our flagship product, Bonita, well, we can help you create seamless applications on top of processes that you already have or either will have in the future. As a digital transformation platform, we are BPM-based, and we use BPMN notation to build what we call the living application. Our platform is highly extensible and highly customizable. It is also low-code, which is different than no-code. Therefore, we are not gearing it towards citizen developers. Today's webinar is very interesting. The title is Evoke Technologies Presents the Integration of OKTA Identity Federation with Bonita, and it's presented by our official premier partner, Evoke Technologies. They're an information technology services company offering leading-edge technology services. They actively help global enterprises innovate and transform their businesses. Your hosts are Harry Prasad Ala, a BPM practice lead, and Salvador Pena, BPM practice director, both from Evoke Technologies. Before we get started, just a little bit of housekeeping. We invite you all to actively take part by submitting any questions or comments that you might have into the chat or questions window located at the bottom of your GoToWebinar dashboard, and our webinar host will try to answer as many questions as possible. So without further ado, I'd like to hand it over to Hari and Salvador.
Thank you, Nicola. Good morning, afternoon, evening, everybody, depending on where you are in the world. My name is Salvador Pena. I lead BPM solutions for Evoke Technologies. We have, let me get the slides in order here. There's our faces. For some reason, my picture is a lot fuzzier than Hari's is. Hari's a good-looking guy. I don't know what's going on with me on the left there, but that's us. Hari is our chief architect from a Bonitasoft perspective, so any of our solutioning, enterprise-level assessments, basically your project oversight, coming up with what the best approach is from an innovation perspective to advance the ROI and competitive advantage position of an organization, that's Hari. I kind of make sure all of our solutions are similar from a cutting-edge innovation perspective, and also make sure that our delivery and the people that we're putting in the chair are the best condition possible. Quick agenda, introduction, which we're doing right now. Next slide will be an overview on who is Evoke Technologies, what do we do, what's our relationship with Bonitasoft. Hari is going to walk us through a user authentication use case in Bonitasoft, give us an overview of OKTA, Bonita's integration to OKTA, put a demo up for you guys so you can have something to chew on, a walk through the code, and then we'll QA basically anything and everything you guys want to ask. Feel free to ask away. So Evoke Technologies, we are an advanced software services firm that was established about 15 years ago, 2003. We've been a premier partner of Bonitasoft since 2015. We have corporate offices spread a little bit all over the U.S. And one primary development center in India. A little bit over 500 people that are dedicated to strictly project delivery. So those are not leadership roles. Those are strictly developers and analysts. Dedicated roles. We don't have people crossbreed that much. We're more of a fan of shadowing and trickle-down knowledge, but there's not people pulling four roles on the same project. So you have your architects, your process analysts, your developers, testers, production support teams, and in some cases, rarely, some clients require more specialized expertise roles, such as machine learning, AI, things of that sort, so we staff those as needed. From a Bonitasoft perspective, We have implemented successfully over 40 enterprise level business processes. We're currently part of one of the largest pharmaceutical companies in the world, their digital transformation at the enterprise level journey. Originally they were operating a little siloed. We have got them on the enterprise perspective now, and we are looking at their processes across everything from R&D, back office, traditional operations in pharma, and even some of the more organizational unique processes, and figuring out how to get all of the data consumed in such a way where their inheritance is in the right place, so that way these processes can be automated easily at minimal cost to the client, but maximize the ROI that this type of digital transformation brings to the client. Some of the solutions that we've worked on, clinical trails, digitization, data steward workflows, government regulations and compliance. With any implementation, typically, especially if it's financial services, medical, healthcare, insurance, whatever the case may be, there's a tremendous amount of compliance. So having the experience on that side of the house and having done it a multitude of times makes it very easy to set up frameworks and layering in such a way where we could really maximize the benefit of that without having too much cost to go to it at the same time. Assets tracking, so you know, you can compare this to your inventory, being able to track all the way from the bill of materials all the way through the product life cycle from the point it gets to the customer to the point it's refurbished to scrap. Financial approvals, custom workflows, so basically your case management, regardless of how many different routes a case can possibly take, it's, you know, relatively simple for us to set up, even in advanced case management when, you know, something can go 20 different directions at the start of a process, but you need to make sure you maintain your audit trail and your data compliance, and also your typical back office operations. As I mentioned before, you know, there's a lot of organizations that have they have been doing things the same way for a very long time, such as financial closure at the end of month. It's being done on spreadsheets. One of the clients I just got finished working with, Fortune 50 client, you would have never thought that they were on spreadsheets. Whole organization ran on spreadsheets. So you'd be surprised. So don't be shy when we get to QA. If you have a business issue, even if it's unrelated to what we're bringing up on this webinar, and you'd like to, you know, get our opinion as to how, you know, to best approach or how to move forward, we'd be more than happy to provide that. So with that said, that's it for the technologies overview. Hari is going to walk us through a use case now and get us rolling into the guts of the presentation. So Hari, I'm going to pass it over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Sal, for the quick introduction. Hello, everyone. Yeah, before we move into, you know, the look into the details of how Bonita can be integrated with the OKTA Identity Federation, let us understand the user authentication process in the Bonita soft, right? So Bonita provides an intuitive user interface for web and mobile access, such that the actors of the business process can work on their assigned tasks, you know, and of course the administrators can monitor the, you know, the running processes and take corrective actions. And technical team, you know, could manage the artifacts through deployment and support, etc. Right? So the user authentication of all these users is managed through, you know, out-of-the-box JAS authentication, which is also called a standard authentication process in Bonita. You know, the IDP for the standard authentication is basically sits within the Bonita general database. But as we understand, enterprise needs are, you know, beyond the standard authentication or the local authentication. The reason being, enterprises encompasses multiple line of business applications, ranges from, you know, homegrown solutions to the cloud applications, which requires the federation identity. You know, part of that being, you know, users wanted to, you know, use single set of credentials, but allow them to, you know, easily, you know, flow through into different applications sitting in their enterprise, which is also called a single sign-on, right? So there are majorly there are two kinds of SSO protocols that is popularly used. One is, as we understand, SAML protocol, which is an XML based protocol, and the other one is OpenID Connect, which is advanced version of OAuth 2.0, and of course it's a JSON based protocol. Bonita Enterprise Edition, aligns with this Identity Federation, which is the requirement or the need in today's world in an enterprise, and supports through the SAML 2.0 protocol, the single sign-on mechanism with any IDP. The diagram that depicts on the screen actually, the multiple mechanisms that are actually presented in the Bonitasoft to integrate with the different authentication mechanisms. So the first one that you see here is the JAS way of integrating to the user authentication. So one is the standard authentication that we just discussed, which runs behind the Bonita general database where the identity stores are configured. When an enterprise has any inbuilt CAS service that is running, the Bonita supports through a CAS protocol, the grant tokens can be, tickets can be retrieved from the CAS service for the user authentication. When it comes to Enterprise Edition, which supports whatever the two authentication mechanisms that we just discussed, above that it also supports any identity federation integration through a SAML protocol. So Bonita has an inbuilt KeyClock SAML adapter module, which actually takes care of integration to these identity providers. So we'll go in detail of how this SAML integration runs, the different flows and different modules involved in the coming slides. Right. Let us also quickly, run through about OKTA. So OKTA is an identity provider, as I just mentioned. Any identity provider supports, creation of identity stores, maintaining, and also managing these identity stores, and exposes these identity services such that the relying parties, usually called as service providers, consume these authentication services for the identity management. Some of the popular IDPs apart from OKTA, as we know, Microsoft Azure Active Directory, WSO2, which are known as commercial identity as a services, and a couple of open source like Shibboleth and KeyClock are IDPs available in open source. And each identity provider definitely provides more or less covers same set of services like policy management, single sign-on, authorization, everything, but each one has distinguished capabilities in its own strong areas. Like OKTA is very strong in supporting access, wide variety of access policy management, for example. Considering other salient features of the OKTA, it's a cloud-based identity as a service and also supports on-prem through an agent installation, of course, and supports a single sign-on, API authorization, which is typical basic need into today's enterprise, and access policy management, network range, location-based, any wide range of access policies can be configured, multi-factor authentication, more secured way of, authentication, and of course for the administrations, reporting and auditing kind of things, such that what kind of login activities are happening on the identity servers, and support, as sometimes enterprises, some of the systems may be tightly coupled with the legacy IDPs. In such cases, OKTA also support delegation to certain those systems identity authorizations to that legacy IDPs, still continue with the new systems with the OKTA as an IDP. Yeah, so popularly there are two approaches that well known in the SSO integration world. One is the service provided initiated flow, and the second one is identity provided initiated flow. So let's look at service provided initiated flow. In the service provided initiated flow, when user tries to access Bonita portal, or for that matter, you know, in this case, we are talking about Bonita and OKTA as a service, Bonita as a service provider and OKTA as an identity provider. So when user tries to log into service provider, which is a Bonita portal, and there is a authentication strategy configured as a SAML authentication strategy, the SAML adapter will filter the request and intercepts that coming in and checks for if there is any session, API session is available in the engine. There is no API session, which means it's a new request. So it redirects the request to the OKTA, which is a 302 request in HTTP terminology, and passes this SAML request XML to the OKTA identity provider. Now, what OKTA does is, you know, it sees whether the request is new request or, you know, already assertion happened. If it is a new request, you know, it challenges the user by throwing a login page, and user will now need to enter the credentials on this login page. And once the login is successful and, you know, authentication happens within the OKTA identity store, and there will be, it redirects the user, you know, by throwing, you know, by passing the SAML response to Bonita portal. Now, Bonita portal, there is a SAML adapter which intercepts anything that is coming in. It looks at the SAML response that is coming from OKTA and takes care of different activities like session creation and token creation within Bonita, and, you know, continues to display the page to the user, the Bonita portal page. And this is a very simple, you know, when compared to SP initiated flow, this is an identity provided initiated flow. In this case, what happens is user actually logs into the OKTA identity provider, you know, the portal of the OKTA. And once the login is success on the OKTA portal, it actually displays the different apps that are configured in the IDP server. In the IDP terminology or in the OKTA terminology, it is called as chiclet. When user clicks on this chiclet to, you know, to navigate to the Bonita portal, so it actually sends the SAML response to the, again, which is going to be intercepted on the Bonita side by the SAML adapter, which is sitting in the Bonita engine, you know, and it takes care of, you know, the session creation for the engine and token creation and things like that, and forwards the request to the portal. And these are the, you know, the step-by-step how this OKTA and Bonita integration happens. You know, on the step one, what we are seeing here is, you know, we are going to set up a Bonita app or a chiclet in the OKTA, right? Some of the important parameters that we are going to configure is the single sign-on URL, which is actually when a request is submitted after authentication on the OKTA, this is the URL that is going to be called. This is basically a SAML adapter interceptor URL, you know, if you see /Bonita/SAML, right? And the recipient URL, destination URL, usually same as your single sign-on URL, unless otherwise we have any different destination that user we would like to redirect after successful authentication on the IDP side. This is the entity ID that is basically a mapped between the Bonita SAML assertion. When response goes back based on this entity ID, it actually SAML adapter intercepts this request. And once the Bonita app is configured on the OKTA side, so what we need to do is we need to assign the users that are authorized or, you know, to access this application. So that can be achieved either through groups or, you know, specific users also can be assigned. In this case, we have just assigned a group of users which are allowed to access this Bonita application. In step three, once the application is configured and users are assigned, the application in the OKTA actually shows us the some of the steps that need to be followed to configure on the IDP side. So one of the things that it provides us is the SSO URL that need to be configured on the service provider side. You know? And if the requests are signed requests, The OKTA also provides a certificate, you know, for the signing request, the responses that is going to be, you know, decrypted on the service provider side. You know, so this is the certificate that we need to configure on the service provider, that is Bonita side. So these two settings we are going to take and configure on the service provider side. And now we move on to Bonita side step. You know, now the first step is in the Bonita side, we need to configure the user, right? The users that are allowed on the OKTA side to access the Bonita application, the same users we are going to configure on the Bonita side, right? For example, there is a user, the screen shows, that need to be configured. The catch here is the usernames that are defined on the OKTA side should be same as usernames on the Bonita side. So username is the one which actually, you know, automatically signs in when user is redirected from OKTA to Bonita. So once users are configured on the Bonita side, so there is a configuration called key clock SAML adapter XML. In that XML, whatever the single sign-on URL and certificate that we have received on the OKTA app side, they will be configured on the, you know, on the binding URL, which is a post request to the IDP that need to be posted when a request is intercepted. So this URL will be configured on the SAML settings of the Bonita, and also certificate that we have received, such that, you know, signed responses can be asserted on the Bonita side. You know, apart from the key clock XML, which is a SAML settings XML, there are a couple of settings that we need to change on the Bonita engine side, you know, which is called as Bonita tenant custom properties, Bonita tenant custom XML, where the Bonita SAML adapter bean will be configured. You know, we'll see that, you know, when we actually do the demo. Okay, let me just quickly run the demo in the demo server that we have. This is the demo server that we have configured on the AWS. So I'm trying to access now Bonita portal, which is running in the AWS server. What happens is, because this Bonita portal is configured and intercepted with SAML adapter, it actually redirects to the OKTA, right? That is the step one that we are going to see. Now I'm selecting the Bonita demo portal /Bonita, which is actually trying to redirect to OKTA, right? So this is the OKTA login page. If you look at, so let me again show you what exactly happened behind the scenes. Just wanted to show how the redirection happens, you know. So I'm trying to access Bonita portal /Bonita, which is trying to access portal homepage, but, you know, there was a SAML adapter configured, so it redirected to IDP for the authentication, you know, instead of using standard authentication. If you look at the URL, we tried to access, you know, Bonita, and it redirected to homepage, which is actually intercepted by SAML adapter, right? And the SAML adapter knows now who is the identity provider for this, right? So it actually redirected to the OKTA, which is sitting at this URL, right, by posting the request. In the request body, you can see the SAML request that is being passed to the OKTA server. You know, this actually contains the issuer ID and all those, such that when response comes, it passes that issuer ID back. Okay, so we can actually decode this SAML request. And, you know, this is the standard Base64 decoding that we could do, and look at what is being passed in this XML. you know, but in the interest of time, I will not go into detail, but this is how the redirection happened from Bonita to OKTA Identity Server through the SAML adapter. Okay, now let me enter. I will clear the existing network logs, and I'm going to provide the user credentials on the OKTA. Let's look at what is happening. It is signing into Evoke Bonita and it is redirecting back to the Bonita portal page. Right. Now let's look at what exactly happened behind the scenes. Now when OKTA login page is submitted, it actually executed an authentication API, you know, in the OKTA. And it does some redirect, session cookie redirect within the OKTA. And this is the important step, you know. So once the authentication happened on the OKTA with the credentials that is being submitted by the user, this is the single sign-on URL that we have configured in the Bonita app that is being configured on the OKTA side, right? So this is the single sign-on URL. So this is actually the SAML adapter URL on the Bonita side. So once the login is successful, it is actually redirecting HTTP 302, which is the redirection to this URL, which is the Bonita URL, right? And it passes the SAML response along with this URL. So this is important. So again, this is the base64 encoded SAML assertion, you know, which we can actually decode and see what exactly is there. So if you look at, it will have entire assertion and digital certificates and everything, you know, but what is important is it will have the status and the user that is going to be mapped and signed in into the Bonita engine side, because this is the response that is going to the Bonita side to this recipient URL, right? And it contains the status, you know, that talks about whether it is a success or failure, you know. So overall, you know, if we go into deep of these, those are the some of the, you know, the status of this authentication and who is the user, you know, that need to be, you know, who is the trusted user that the service provider can actually, you know, allow them to access. And if we have more attributes that can be configured, like groups and, you know, all the policies can also be part of this SAML assertion that is going to be sent. So once the user is redirected back to portal, so user can perform whatever the portal activities that are available to the user. So in this, so the overall point is, so user is actually authenticated on the IDP, not on the Bonita engine side. Okay. Now let's look at SAML settings. I will quickly walk through different settings that have been configured. So this is the AWS server I'm trying to access through FTP. I'm going to go to the current tenant. That is where the user will be accessed. So let me look at tenant engine. So these are the two property files that are going to be modified for the OKTA configuration. So in this configuration, Bonita actually provides different ways of authentication that we have just mentioned, which is the JAS authentication, CAS protocol authentication. So based on the authentication configuration, we are going to provide the, you know, uncomment respective authentication properties. In our case, we are using SAML 2 integration, so we need to uncomment these two properties, which is actually, you know, the bean references for the SAML authentication services, right? Once we uncomment these two SAML authentication properties, so there is a bean that is going to be defined in this custom XML. If you look at, so this is the bean that is going to be intercepted through the SAML integration. So these are the properties that are actually, you know, referred in that properties file, right? So this bean will get intercepted when the SAML request comes in. So once we make these changes, which are actually the authentication service changes for the SAML adapter, and in the tenant portal, there is a main properties file for the SAML properties, which is called as key clock SAML XML. So in this SAML XML, as in the screenshot also we have seen, so on the IDP configuration that you see here, it contains SP configuration and the IDP configuration, right? In the IDP configuration, what we are going to do is, in the single sign-on service, we are going to provide the OKTA single sign-on URL. This is the single sign-on URL when we configured Bonita app on the OKTA side. You know, the SAML metadata provides us this URL on the OKTA side. So that URL we are going to configure. This is going to be a post request, and where with the SAML, when the user logs in, this URL will be posted with the SAML request. Okay. And this is the key certificate that is provided by the OKTA for, you know, assertions, checking the signed assertions on the Bonita side once a response is received. Okay. So this is the main settings on the key clock side. And along with that, this is the authentication properties. So wherein, so this is the module that is going to be intercepted for every request. So where we are saying that we wanted to use SAML authentication module, not the standard authentication module, right? So we are going to comment standard authentication module and uncomment SAML authentication module, such that every request is intercepted with this module. And if you look at a few properties here, what actually it does is, though the SAML authentication module is activated, where every request is intercepted by this and redirected to the OKTA for the authentication, but still on the Bonita side, we can also allow standard authentication true. You know, standard authentication of the users can be allowed. So let me show you how that happens. So when user access slash Bonita URL, it always goes to the SAML authentication module. But the standard authentication comes when user try to log in with the standard login page of the Bonita portal. So this one doesn't get intercepted by the OKTA SAML integration, you know. So this will still show the standard Bonita login page, where administrators or people like that, they can still access the Bonita portal to the standard authentication. And if user access without standard authentication, it will be intercepted by the SAML adapter. Okay. So this is the property that actually, you know, allows that standard authentication on the Bonita side. Okay. So these are the standard properties, different properties that we need to set up on the Bonita side. And so those are the overall, you know, so different authentication mechanisms includes the standard and SAML integration protocols that can be implemented in Bonitasoft to meet the enterprise needs. So with that, I would be happy to, if there are any questions, I would be happy to answer. Thank you.
Hey, Hari, there's a question or two popping up on the question tab. Can you take a look?
Sure. Yes. So can we integrate with Azure AD? Right. So as we just seen, the Bonitasoft provides out-of-the-box integration with some of these identity providers through SAML adapter, right? If that IDP, that could be Azure AD or WSO2, as long as they provide SAML 2.0 protocol integration, so Bonita can be integrated. It's about the protocol, how they are going to support. So it's not dependent on IDP exactly. So if they support SAML 2.0, so we can definitely integrate with Microsoft Azure AD. But having said that, if SAML is not supported by that IDP, for example, now what we could do is, the one of the beauty part of the Bonitasoft is it's an open source code, so we can always inject our custom filters through the, to access that respective identity provider authentication services, and get the token from the authentication respective identity authentication service and create the respective sessions needed on the Bonita engine and redirect the user to the portal. For example, OAuth 2.0 or OpenID Connect is can be achieved by adding a simple servlet filter or a web filter within the Bonitasoft and connect to that respective authentication service and allow the user access Bonita portal. Right. So yeah, if Azure AD supports SAML, definitely, it is nothing different from OKTA, right? It depends on the SAML assertion.
Okay, we also invite everybody to post any more questions that they might have as we get close to the end of our webinar. Thank you, Harry. Thank you, Salvador, for a great presentation. If you'd like to discuss in more details about your ongoing projects or future goals, please feel free to reach out via our contact form. I've added links to the contact form for Bonitasoft in the chat area in the dashboard. Also, if you would like to learn more about Evoke Technologies, there's a link to their website there. So let me just double check if there's any new questions. Hari, it looks like we have an extra question over there in the question box.
Sure, Nicola. Yeah, comparing JAS and SAML. Right? SAML is a single sign-on protocol, whereas JAS is out of the box Java standard authentication and authorization module provided by any OpenJDK, right? It provides you an abstraction to manage your user authentication or build your own custom user authentication components within your enterprise. But SAML is beyond, your standard local authentication modules. It's a more used for federated identity across, to multiple systems. I mean, they are not in other way they are not comparable,
Okay, looks like we don't have any new questions coming in, and that Hari answered all the ones that were posted. Once again, if you do have any additional questions, please feel free to reach out at any point, either to Bonitasoft or Evoke, and we'd be happy to provide you more information. Once again, thank you, Hari and Salvador, for a great presentation, great interesting topic. We'd like to thank all the attendees for your time today, and we hope you have a great rest of your day wherever you are in the world. Stay tuned for some additional Bonita webinars coming up shortly. Everything will be posted on our website, and you can find a recording of this webinar shortly on our website and YouTube channel, and our Vimeo channel also. So once again, from Bonitasoft and Evoke Technologies, we'd like to thank you all, and have a great day. Thanks.